quit, and I play the cow.
I'm Mackenzie, and I play Mary.
I'm Kale, and I play the narrator.
I'm Mason, and I'm Bug.
I'm Paige, and I'm playing Dove.
I'm Josie, and I play the dove.
I'm Owen, and I play Dove too.
No,
Soldier
Two. Soldier Two.
I'm Winnie, and I play narrator.
I'm Lizzie, and I play the sheep.
I am Adam, and I play the Soldier One.
Continuous knocking on the innkeeper's door. And to top it all off, our innkeeper has forgotten to bring us more food. There's very little fresh hay left. Woo!
The innkeeper has been too busy to think about us. People have been coming from all over to stay at the inn. Caesar has a decree that everyone must go to his own town to be taxed. That's why Bethlehem is so crowded.
Well, I'm glad it's finally getting done. Most of the people are sleeping, and this little town is quiet and still once again.
Scene two.
What do you want?
Need a room with this inn.
A room? This inn is full. All the inns are in Bethlehem. It's very late now.
But we must have a place to stay till my wife is ready to give birth.
Come with me. You can stay in that stable. It's the best.
Soft place to lay.
special relationship still exists among the cows and children today, for it is from the cow that we get milk from.
Scene 4.
Stayed for a time while Mary and Joseph held the sleeping child. After the shepherds left, Mary and Joseph decided to get some rest.
Scene 6.
So the little brown bug took away the piece of straw that had been hurting the baby Jesus.
There, the baby has stopped crying.
The little bug, what's that beautiful light on your tail?
The little bug looked back at his tail. It was blowing on and off. His tail had touched the head of Jesus as he removed the straw piece. Now his tail was filled with the radiant glow of the halo, which was around the baby's head. That is how God blessed the bug for his kind deed, and that's how a plain brown bug became the lightning bug. It was not long before visitors from afar came to pay homage to the newborn king. The animals heard their approach.
Scene 8.
Who are these men? Last flight to Jerusalem, I saw the same men at Herod's chest. Herod told them to go to Bethlehem and then to bring the news of the newborn. Herod was talking to others. He wishes the baby's home.
Traveling in a different direction. Some of Herod's spies noticed this and told Herod. Herod sent some men to try to catch up to the kings. He wanted the men to find out where baby Jesus was. One night, while the wise men lay sleeping, the rooster started crowing very loudly. The rooster had been flying about and knew that Herod's men were only an hour distance away. The wise men could not sleep with all the crowing, so they packed their things and got an early start. Thanks to the rooster, Herod's men never caught up to the kings.
Scene 9.
No.
Well, you ever read?
No. I never read.
I never read.
Now all this time, in the little stable, there had been a quiet little spider. Not even the animals had noticed it.
Stop, please. Let's go back to your parts.
Mary's tears of joy got caught in the spider's web.